Everyone loves a good sports story, where the underdog rises to the top, labels are finally destroyed, and the veteran star goes out of chance. But besides the feel-good stories, everyone also enjoys a good choke story. It's what everyone talks about, it becomes all the buzz. And especially when it's an underdog team that no one expected to win, that takes down a powerhouse who was supposed to win it all. Last year's NHL playoffs were very unpredictable and full of upsets, but one series in particular in the first round became known as one of the biggest choke jobs in recent NHL history. Before we begin, I want to give a huge shout out to SeatGeek for sponsoring today's video. SeatGeek is an app that allows users to purchase tickets to games, concerts, and live events. SeatGeek makes buying tickets simple as they rate them on a scale of 1 to 100. The higher the number, the better the deal. So if you haven't already, use my promo code IDGT at checkout to save $20 off your first purchase. Now, let's get into it. The two teams we'll be talking about had two unique ways of getting to where they are up to this point. The Tampa Bay Lightning popped off. They were in a league of their own, 62 wins, the President's Trophy, and were oh so close to making NHL history. Led by captain Steven Stamkos and electric Nikita Kucherov, the Lightning were instant Stanley Cup favorites. However, the Lightning's reputation up to this point was not the greatest. The last time the Cup was in Tampa Bay was in 2004, and ever since, they've been trying to get back to their former glory. They would lose in the Stanley Cup final in 2015 and would derail from not even making the playoffs at all to even two Eastern Conference final losses, the Lightning were always known as being close, but never close enough. They were hoping to finally destroy their choker label and get the monkey off their back. And if anything, this looked like the team that could do just that. Facing the Lightning, the Columbus Blue Jackets took a completely different route to getting into the postseason. With two of their top stars most likely leaving in free agency, the Jackets figured they had nothing to lose and went all in at the trade deadline, acquiring two other potential free agents in Duchesne and Dzingel, and trading away young players, prospects, and some pretty high-valued picks. With these moves being made, it was a risk-over-reward type of play, not only with the Jackets bolstering up for a deep playoff run, but for a run in general, as they were the only team in the league to have never won a playoff series to this point. Almost everyone had the Lightning destroying the Jackets in the series and plowing their way to the Cup. However, the first game played between the two teams would signify how the rest of the series would pan out.
A breakaway. Foligno roars in. He scores! Nick Foligno. Columbus's captain comes through. Little toe track. He's right in. He scores! What a goal by David Savard! And with 12:04 left in regulation, Columbus is within one. He'll cut through the slot. Anderson shot scores! Josh Anderson with a shorthanded goal. It's a new story. Game one is tied. It over around the clock. Panarin and now Jones with a shot. He scores! Columbus has climbed that mountain and now they're at the top with 5:55 left. They have a 4-3 lead.
His come-from-behind victory was shocking in its own. The Jackets were able to upset the Lightning while in Tampa Bay. Everyone already considered this a job well done for the Jackets and were still counting them out, but they weren't done yet. They knew that one game wasn't going to win them a series.
Game number two, and we'll see if the Tampa Bay Lightning will have that response by Matthew Shane. Out in front, what a stop, but a leap throw! Cam Atkinson got to it, and Columbus right on the spot. Boston sees it go, Werenski! Series has become a stunning story. Zach Werenski, his shot goes off Vasilevsky, they score! On the rebounds to the outside, Bjorkstrand scores! Atkinson, bullseye!
Now with the Jackets being within one game of not only advancing, but sweeping the President's Trophy winners, everyone was in awe. Bobrovsky looked like a brick wall, and their stars acquired at the deadline, along with Panarin and the defense, were all clicking at once. They knew they were the underdogs, and were all rallying around the city and the fans. With one game remaining, they wouldn't disappoint.
Better in front of this crowd.
It says, thank you, 4-3 Columbus.
A chance, but Bronski says no. score! And Kevin Panarin buries it!
For the first time in their franchise history, the Columbus Blue Jackets have advanced in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
This moment will become one of the most talked about in recent history. The number one seed getting swept by a wild card team who no one expected to even stand a fighting chance. To not even win a single game against them after winning 62 games prior was just a slap in the face. The Jackets would eventually lose to Boston in the next round, but this was a big step for this Jackets team who was finally able to pull off a playoff series win. And as for Tampa Bay, all can be summarized by their own words. We don't have any words, and we know you don't want to hear them. We understand your anger, your frustration, your sadness, everything you're feeling, we get it. This isn't the ending we imagined, and certainly not the one we wanted. Thank you for being there the entire way.
Right in front of me. You guys are really good at this. Last year you were up 2-0 too. How did it end up?